Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ashland Middle School for the final regular season game for Ashland Legion Post 77 as they welcome in Sudbury Post 191. Connor Donovan on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. You're tuned in to Ashland Legion Baseball on WACA-TV in Ashland or HCAM Television in Hopkinton. Let's take a look at the Ashland Post 77 field. Miles DeSoni is getting the start today on the mound. Zach Jacobs behind the plate. Ronan Bates at first. Ethan Tominski at second. Trevor DePeron at shortstop. Mike Messier at third. From left to right, Samir Sharma, Andrew Keim, and Devin Del Campo for the final Post 77 game of the season. Ashland pulling off three wins this week, one by way of the forfeit, and the other two wins. Some good offensive production, an 8-1 victory over Woburn on Monday, and then on Tuesday, a solid 9-8 comeback win over Natick, who at the time was seeking a playoff spot, but more than likely is now out of the race. Sudbury very much in the playoff race. They have clinched a spot, but they are still fighting for seeding. As the first pitch is hit in the air, Adam Generoso, the batter, ranging over to make the catch is the second baseman, Ethan Tominski, one away. And that'll bring up Scott Holzwasser, the shortstop. Let's take a look at the Sudbury lineup. Scott Holzwasser coming to the plate now. He's the shortstop. Gino Fortiani is the center fielder batting third. Jacob Sashua, the first baseman, hitting cleanup. Ethan McAuliffe, the third baseman, hitting fifth as the first pitch is a strike to Holzwasser. Devin Pathick, the second baseman, hitting sixth. Gino Fortiani, the center fielder, hitting seventh. Rylan Forrester, the catcher, hitting eighth. And Peter Upham, the right fielder, hitting ninth. The windup and the pitch. That's fouled away. Jonathan Rowe is the pitcher for Sudbury Post 191. As DeSoni set to deliver the 0-2 pitch. That one down low. Taking a look at the standings, Lowell is in first at 13-2. Then you got Newton at 11-3. Sudbury's 10-3. They play tomorrow, their final regular season game. So they still have a shot for that first playoff spot as that's hit in the air behind the backstop foul. And then Hudson has clinched the fourth spot. They're 9-6 overall. They're in action today. But Natick, they fell out of contention with the loss to Ashland last night. They're now 7-8. Wind up and the pitch from DeSoni. That pitch just outside, 2-2 to Holzwasser. Sudbury is led by head coach Len Noche, assisted by Ed Blum and Dan Buckley. Wind up and the pitch. Hit in the air, a high pop-up above the pitcher's mound, and coming in to make the catch is Mike Messier. Two away. Messier had a battle of the sun there. Another beautiful sunny day for the last regular season game for Ashland Post 77. Temperatures in the high 80s. Gino Fortiani steps to the plate, the center fielder. DeSoni deals. And there's a strike. 0-1. Sony's been the two-starter, really, for Ashland throughout the season. Wind up and the pitch behind Andrew Keim as that one's fouled away. Keim unavailable for today's game. Ashland will continue playing in the Commissioner's Cup, which is essentially for the team's that did not make the postseason as that pitch down low. 1-2 on Fortiani. DeSoni set to deliver. That one down low. 2-2. Georgia. Miles DeSoni, graduated this year from Ashland High School. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air over to center field, and ranging over to make the catch is Keim for the third out of the inning. To the bottom of the first we go. It's a scoreless game between Sudbury and Ashland. Bottom of the first inning, Ashland post 77 coming to the plate for their first time today. Let's take a look at their lineup as they are hoping to continue their winning ways in the last week of the season. Trevor DePera on the shortstop will bat first. Michael Krupe, the DH, will bat second. Samir Sharma, the left fielder, will bat third. Zach Jacobs, the catcher in the cleanup spot. Mike Messier, the third baseman, batting fifth. Ronan Bates, the first baseman, batting sixth. Andrew Keim, the center fielder, batting seventh. Ethan Tominski, the second baseman, batting eighth. Devondale Campo, the right fielder, batting ninth. And Miles DeSoni, the pitcher. As far as the Sudbury field, Jonathan Rowe on the mound. His battery mate is Ryan Forrester. Jake Sashua over at first base. Devin Pathick, the second baseman. Scott Holzwasser, the shortstop. And Ethan McAuliffe over at third base. From left to right, Tom Garcia, Gino Fortiani, and Peter Upham. As DePeron steps to the plate, had the game-tying hit and a comeback win against Natick. And it was a light-shortened game as the first pitch just outside. They played six innings in that game. The game started late due to a late arrival by an umpire. Actually, the original umpire was unable to get here, so they had another umpire come in. It was actually Hopkinton native Michael Whalen, who is one of the umpires for high school baseball and Legion baseball. He came in substitution, and we were able to play ball as this one is hit in the air, foul territory, and it's going to make the count 1-2 on the lefty. Rowe waits the sign and is set to deliver. Swinging strike. DePeron goes down, one away. They will bring up Michael Krupe, the designated hitter. Krupe has been a pretty good asset with the bat for post 77 this season. Ashland trying to spoil Sudbury's hopes at that one seed here in this game today. There's a swinging strike. Rowe set to deal. Swinging strike. Blazing fastball by Rowe. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. John Rowe out of Lincoln Sudbury High School, graduated this year. Rowe deals, that's fouled away. Off the catcher. Count remains 0-2. Rowe delivers, and this is up the middle, takes a hop on the infield grass, played by the shortstop, throw over to first, no problem for Holzwasser, good throw across the diamond, a 6-3 ground out for Krupe, two away. Samir Sharma, the left fielder, coming up to the plate. Sharma has contributed nicely in this last week of the season, both with the bat and on the diamond. Yeah. Wind up in the pitch. Down low. Rowe set the deal. There's a strike, 1-1. Rowe delivers. That took a bounce off the dirt. Almost looked like he was trying to throw a knuckleball there. And this is going to take a couple hops on the third base side, but foul, 2-2. Certainly a humid day today. A little bit more hot than it was yesterday. Relatively hot week overall as this is hit in the air. A high fly ball over to shallow center field. And ranging over to make the catch is the center fielder, Gino Fortiani, and they go down 1-2-3 in the bottom half of the first. To the top of the second we go. It's a scoreless game between Sudbury and Ashland. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the second inning. Sudbury back up to the plate. They went down 1-2-3 in the first, so 4, 5, and 6. As Jacob Sashua, the first baseman, steps in to face DeSoni. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike, 0-1. Should be a pretty good pitching matchup here today between DeSoni and John Rowe. Sony deals. There's strike two. Sony set to deliver. And this is hit in the air into left field. That'll drop in for a base hit and roll all the way to the fence. Rounding first is Sashua, and he is going to round second base but head back to the bag with a stand-up double. Ethan McAuliffe, the third baseman, due up next. So a leadoff double for post 191. Sony set to deliver, runner leading off of second. First pitch is in there for a strike. Sony takes a look at Sashua, now delivers. Down low, got away from Jacobs. Sashua is going to head down to third. On the pass ball, a 1-1 count on McAuliffe. That pitch was a little too far inside. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Sony set to deal. That one just low, 2-2. Sony working from the stretch. And that is hit foul beyond the backstop. Count remains 2-2 on the third baseman. Leg lift and the pitch. Just outside, full count. Ethan McAuliffe, set to graduate Lincoln Sudbury High School next year. And there's strike three. McAuliffe reached for it. And a good pitch by DeSoni, out number one. Devin Pathick, the second baseman, will come up to the plate. Pathick also at a Lincoln Sudbury High School. He'll graduate in with the class of 2017 as well. Runner leading off of third. There's a strike. One on, one out for Sudbury. Top half of the second, a scoreless game. Sony with the leg lift and the pitch. And there's strike two. Nice pitch on the outer corner. Sony deals. And this is going to take a hop on the infield dirt. And a nice job by Ronan Bates. Looked over at third, made sure the runner stayed put, and took it unassisted for the second out. Good defensive play. That'll bring up Gino Fortiani. Fortiani also at a Lincoln Sudbury High School, graduated last year. And that is certainly one of the parts of the game that Ashland has gotten significantly better throughout the season at is their defense. It has improved dramatically. And the young players on this team certainly getting some very good experience and becoming better players. The windup and the pitch. That one up high, 1-1. Sony looks over at the runner and now is set to deliver. And this is crushed into center field, and jumping up, making the catch is Kime. Good catch by Kime in center field. Ball was just about to sail over his head, gave a nice leap, and pulled it down, and we will head to the bottom of the second. It's a scoreless game between Sudbury and Ashland. 4, 5, and 6 hitters coming up to the plate for Ashland. Zach Jacobs, Mike Messier, Ronan Bates. Here on the bottom of the second, some good defensive plays in the top half of the inning by Ashland to get out of the inning unscathed after Jacobs Shashua led it off with a double. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. 0-1 on Jacobs, who has been outstanding behind the plate throughout the season. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is up the third base side, foul. 0-2. Row deals. Breaking ball on the outside, 1-2. And this is up the middle, rolls past the mound, fielded by the shortstop. Good throw to first. Was it in time? Yes, it was. Holzwasser coming up with the throw. That was a good defensive play there. As Jacobs just flew down that line. Mike Messier to the plate with one out. Third baseman steps in. One Wind up and the pitch upstairs. Row deals. There's a strike. One count on the third baseman. And this is up the left side, fielded by McAuliffe over at third. Throw to first, not a problem, two away. Ronan Bates, the first baseman, now coming to the plate. Bates set to deliver. That one down low. Bates has been a solid first baseman for Ashland. And this is up the middle, fielded at by the second baseman. Throw to first, and they go down 1-2-3 in the bottom half of the inning. To the top of the third we go. It's a scoreless game between Ashland and Sudbury. Top half of the third inning. Ryland Forrester, the catcher, leading things off for Sudbury. 8-9-1 due up. First pitch, a strike from DeSoni. And then an overthrow from Jacobs. Looks like the ball slipped out of his hand there. Well, it is certainly humid out there, so that could play a factor in this one. Sony deals, and that is hit foul behind the backstop, 0-2. Sony delivers. Up the middle and fielded it and dropped it by the shortstop, DePeron, and did get the throw off, but it is just late. And Forrester beats it out on the error. And that will bring up Peter Upham, the right fielder. Right fielder steps in, runner leading off of first. The bunt is laid down and foul. Peter Upham out of Concord Carlisle High School, graduated this year. Runner with a slight lead off of first. The leg lift and the check in over at first. Runner back safe. Sony looks over at first and checks in again. Wind up and the pitch upstairs. One pitch just outside. Here's the 2-1, and this is up the middle, a rocket, and dropped once again by the shortstop, but he flips the second for one, throw to first, not in time. Nice recovery by DePeron, who at least get the lead runner, and Upham reaches on the 6-4 fielder's choice. That'll bring up Adam Generoso, the DH. One on, one out. Wind up and the pitch. That one just outside, 1-0. Sony deals. And this is hit in the air. It is going to be in fair territory. And ranging over to make the catch is Samir Sharma. Runner will stay put at first. Two away. Good job by Sharma. Really had a range to his right to get to that one. I'll bring up Scott Holzwasser, the shortstop. Wind up and the pitch. And that is hit in the air right side. Foul territory. Bates can't get to it. Sony from the stretch. Runner leading off of first. And this is crushed over towards left field and foul. That would have more than likely cleared the fence if it stayed fair. 0-2. Sony set to deliver. Runner taking off from first. Ball is low. Gets away from Jacobs. An easy stolen bag for Upham. And actually, they are going to give Holzwasser the pass to first. He must have got hit by that pitch. So they're going to rule it a hit batter. That'll bring up Gino Fortiani with two outs, two on. Runners on first and second. We're going to get a time here. Ashland head coach Derek Johnson might come out to argue this one a little bit. It looked to me as if the ball hit the dirt, but I'd have to watch the tape, which unfortunately we are incapable of at the moment. Sony from the stretch. Both runners leading. And this is first base side. That is going to get through. That's a fair ball. Rounding third base is Upham. One Sudbury run is in. Holzwasser held up at third, and now he's going to come around as the ball got away once again. It's 2-0 Sudbury. So Fortiani reaches second base. You could rule that a, or score that, a two RBI single. He advanced to second on the throw. Holzwasser ends up scoring as well as Upham. That'll bring up Jacob Shashua, the first baseman. And it was an errant exchange there, which allowed that second run to score. And this is hit in the air to center field, and Keim will come up with it. Another good catch by Keim. And we will head to the bottom of the third, but Sudbury does come up with two runs. It's 2-0 post 191 in the lead, heading to the bottom of the inning. Bottom half of the third inning, Sudbury off to a 2-0 lead as they came up with two runs in the top of the inning. 7, 8, and 9 due up for post 77 as Andrew Keim steps to the plate. Keim has made two very good catches today in center field. And he will hit this one in the air, a high fly ball over to right center, and ranging over just to his left is Fortiani to make the catch, one away. Ethan Tominski, the second baseman, now heading to the plate. Devin Del Campo due up after him. Line up and the pitch. And this is lined into right field. Ranging in to make the catch is Upham. Good catch by Upham. Really had a run in to get to that one. Was playing pretty deep out there. Devin Del Campo now coming up to the plate. That one outside. Row deals. That'll make it 2-0. Rowe's been working quickly through these Ashland hitters so far. There's a swinging strike, blazing fastball. Rowe deals. And this is hit in the air, foul territory, third base side. And it is caught by McCullough for the third and final out of the inning. To the top of the fourth we go, Sudbury with a 2-0 lead. Top half of the fourth inning, a 2-0 Sudbury lead. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living. You could find them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Top half of the fourth, Ethan McAuliffe, the third baseman at the plate. And he takes strike one. McAuliffe struck out his last time up in the second inning. And there's strike two. Good breaking ball from DeSoni. 5-6 and 7 due up for Sudbury. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is up the left side and bobbled a little bit by the shortstop. Throw to first is not going to be in time. And that was just a tough one to get to. Kind of was just dug down there in the dirt. I'll score it a single. We'll get the official ruling later. Devin Pathick to the plate. Two errors last inning from Ashland. Pathick grounded out his last time up in the second. Takes ball one there. Runner leading off of first. That one just high. Sony deals, runner taking off from first. The bunt is down, slow roller on the infield. Grass throw to first, and they'll get him. And now the runner's going to head over to third. Throw to third, not in time. McAuliffe gets all the way to third base on the steal as Pathick takes the sacrifice. Well, he stole second and then took third on the sacrifice. And now Gino Fortiani to the plate. Good running there by the third baseman. Runner leading off of third. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Sony deals just outside. One out in the inning, a runner on third. Lined up and the pitch. And this is up the middle and dropped by the shortstop. Runner from third is going to easily score. 3-0 Sudbury. McAuliffe comes around. Fortiani at first on the error. Rylan Forrester will come to the plate. That one did take a awkward bounce, so you could question if that was a hit or an error as well. But for now, I'll score it an error. Catcher steps in. He reached on an error in the third inning. Fouled away. Ended up getting thrown out on a fielder's choice. Still one out in the inning. Runner on first. Another run in for Sudbury. And this is hit in the air over to right field. That's going to drop in past the reach of Del Campo. And being waved around is Fortiani. The throw in is cut off. Now the throw to third is going to be in time to get the hitter. Another run is in for Sudbury as Fortiani comes all the way around. But Forster thrown out, heading over to third after he gets the RBI double. Two away. And now Peter Upham to the plate. Well, a good throw by the cutoff man. You at least get the out there. That one inside. One and oh on the righty. Wind up and the pitch. And this takes a bounce, it looked like off the dirt in front of home plate, into the glove of the shortstop DePera on throw to first, no problem. 6-3 goes Upham, but Sudbury does score two more runs. It's 4-0 heading to the bottom of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth inning, a 4-0 Sudbury lead. 1, 2, and 3 due up for Ashland as the shortstop steps in. And this is hit in the air. It is in fair territory, and the left fielder will make the catch. Good catch by Tom Garcia. Had a range over far to his right to get to that one. Now Michael Krupe to the plate. One pitch, one out. Back-to-back lefties at the top of the order today for Post 77. That one inside. Line up and the pitch. Down low. 2-0 on the designated hitter. And this is a rocket and a great catch by Holzwasser at shortstop. Went down to one knee and was able to hang on to it. Great catch. I looked for sure like it was going to get into left field, but Holzwasser playing deep along the infield dirt as Samir Sharma steps in. And this is hit up the middle, that's going to drop into right field, and Sharma will be aboard with a single. First hit of the game for Post 77. Zach Jacobs will come to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike. Set to deal. Runner leading off of first. There's strike two. Another breaking pitch there from Rowe. Ro working from the stretch, checking at first. They nearly got him. That was very close. Sharma will lead off once again. And this is hit in the air to right field and caught by Upham. That will end the fourth inning. Ashland does get their first hit of the game, but no runs to show for it. To the top of the fifth we go. Sudbury with a 4-0 lead. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Top half of the fifth inning, a 4-0 lead for Sudbury. Miles DeSoni having a pretty good pitching performance today, but a few errors have held Ashland back. Top of the order for Sudbury, Adam Generoso, the DH at the plate. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Sony set to deal. And this is up the middle, gloved by the shortstop to Perron. Throw to first, one away. Shortstop steps in with one out. That one inside, 1-0. Sony deals. And this is a rocket up the third base side, and that is going to be called foul. One and two now on Holzwasser. Set to deliver inside. Two and one the count. That one outside. Sony has not walked anyone in this game. And this is hit in the air to left field and gloved by Sharma. Two away. Gino Fortiani now to the plate. He had a two RBI single in the third. Scored the first two runs of the game for Sudbury. And he will hit this one up the middle, gloved by Tominski. Throw to first, no problem. Fortiani goes down 4-3. To the bottom of the fifth we go. It's 4-0 Sudbury. Bottom of the fifth inning, third baseman Mike Messier stepping in. John Rowe back out there for another inning of work. Pitching a solid game so far as there's strike one. A 4-0 lead for Sudbury. 5-6 and 7 due up for post 77. Wind up and the pitch. Here's strike two. Messier grounded out and is only at bat in the second inning. Messier, Bates, and Keim coming to the plate for Ashland. That one up high. Rowe deals. That one down low. Leg lift and the pitch. That's fouled away. Set to deliver. And this is up the left side, past the reach of the third baseman, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first is not in time. Messier beats it out. Second hit of the game for Post 77. Ronan Bates to the plate. Good piece of hitting there by Messier, showing his speed up that line. Messier leading off of first. That's down low. Rose set to deliver. Inside, and Forster takes a look at first. 2-0. Rowe waits the sign, checking at first. Runner slides back safe. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Delivers, and that is foul up the third base side, 2-2. Runner leading off of first. There's strike three, one away. Keim to the plate. Messier continue to lead off first. As this is hit up the middle, gloved by the shortstop, he'll step on second for one, throw to first, and a nicely executed double play. And that will wrap up the fifth inning. To the top of the sixth we go. Sudbury leading Ashland 4-0. Top half of the sixth inning, 4-5 and six hitters due up for Sudbury as they're off to a 4-0 lead. Miles DeSony pitching a great game. A few errors have allowed Sudbury to continue innings and score a couple. As Jacob Sashua, the first baseman, steps in. He'll take strike one. Sashua, one for two today, doubled in the second. Wind up in the pitch. Down low. Sudbury has another regular season game tomorrow. They're in the playoffs trying to clinch that one or two seed as this is hit in the air to right field, ranging over in foul territory and bobbling it is Del Campo. And actually, they're going to call that one fair, so that is a single for Shashua. It's awfully close to the line. But the umpire with a much better view than we have over here, and that'll bring up Ethan McAuliffe, the third baseman. Runner leading off of first. There's a strike. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike. Sony set to deliver. And this is up the middle, pass to Sony. Glove by the second baseman, throw to first. Was it there in time? And they are going to call him safe. So he was able to beat that out. That took an awkward bounce. It was pretty tough for Tominski to field. It's two on, no outs for Sudbury. Devin Pathick steps in. There's a strike. Right up and the pitch. Down low. One in and one on Pathick, who's 0 for 2 today. Actually, he had a sacrifice. He's 0 for 1. Outside. 2 and 1. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. 3-1 on Pathick. There's the walk. That'll load up the bases with no outs. Gino Fortiani, the center fielder, coming to the plate. Takes a strike there. Good drop on that breaking pitch. Sony deals, fouled away. 0-2 on Fortiani. Reached on an error and scored a run in the fourth. That was the fourth Sudbury run of the day. 4-0 lead, trying to add on here. And this is up the middle, past the reach of the third baseman, gloved by the shortstop, throw to second, and they get one, but a run is in. Sashua comes around to score. McAuliffe up to third. Pathick thrown out. Fortiani reaches on the sacrifice. A 5-0 lead for Sudbury, and now Ryan Forrester to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Up high. Check in at first, runner slides back. One out, runners on the corners, another run in for Sudbury. That one is going to grab the inner corner. One and one. Wind up and the pitch. Up high. Sony set to deliver the 2-1. Runner taking off from first, and no throw from Jacobs. That pitch is a strike. Stolen base by Fortiani. Now two in scoring position. Wind up and the pitch. Upstairs. Ryland Forrester out of Lincoln Sudbury High School, set to graduate next year. Leg lift and the pitch. There's the walk. Second walk of the inning for DeSony. And that will load up the bases with one out for Peter Upham, the right fielder. Wind up and the pitch. Inside. Corner for a strike. Looked inside at first, but must have just got a piece of that corner. And this is going to take a hop on the dirt in front of home plate. Glove by the shortstop. Throw to second for one. Another run in. Throw to first is going to get away. So another run comes around to score as McAuliffe crosses home plate. Forster thrown out, going to second. Fortiani up to third. Upham reaches and has the RBI. Two outs in the inning. Generoso to the plate. Upstairs. Fortiani at third. Upham at first. Now a 6-0 lead for Sudbury. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. The Sony deals. And this is hit in the air to center field. Keim ranging back towards the wall, and he'll make the catch for the third out of the inning. But Sudbury plates two more runs and adds some security. It's 6-0 heading to the bottom of the sixth. Bottom of the sixth inning. A 6-0 lead for Sudbury. Ethan Zhang takes over in left field for post 191 as Ethan Tominski steps to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away. John Rowe still on the mound for Sudbury. He's not throwing a whole lot of pitches, so if he continues his success, we could possibly see him attempt the complete game. As this is hit in the air, popped up on the right side, and the catcher will make the play. Ryland Forrester with the catch. One away, Devin Del Campo to the plate. Post 77 down to their final five outs. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Zero. Rowe set to deal. And this is up the third base side, gloved by McAuliffe. Throw to first, got him. Two away. Trevor DePeron to the plate. Well, it has been a good pitching performance from John Rowe, to say the least. At least up to this point. Sudbury will be happy, I'm sure, if he could stay out all game to rest her arms, as this one's driven into left field, just past the glove of the new left fielder, Zhang, and DePeron's going to round first as it rolls all the way back to the fence. He'll go up to second with the double. Good piece of hitting by DePeron. Certainly a tough play to make out there in left field. And now Michael Krupe to the plate. So with two outs, a runner on second for post 77. It's their third hit of the game. Down low. Rowe deals. That one's low as well, 2-0. Rowe working from the stretch. Runner leading off of second. He'll turn around and throw. Nearly picked off. Good slide back by DePeron. There's a strike, 2-1. That's fouled away, 2-2. And this is up the right side, over to the second baseman, throw to first, they got him. A 4-3 ground out for Krupe, and that will retire the bottom of the 6-0, heading to the seventh. Top half of the seventh inning, a 6-0 lead for Sudbury. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug, located at 52 Main Street. Top of the seventh, stepping in is Scott Holzwasser, the shortstop. DeSoni out there. He'll deliver ball one, 1-0. Sony deals. That's fouled away. 1-1. There's strike two. Holzwasser 0-2. This game was hit by a pitch and scored a run in the third. 2-2. 2-3-4 hitters for Sudbury. And this is crushed into right field towards the wall. That's going to drop in for a hit past El Campo. Holzwasser rounding second, heading to third. The throw in cut off, and then the throw will be over towards the second baseman, but Holzwasser with a stand-up triple. That'll bring up Gino Fortiani. Absolutely tattooed that ball there. It's fouled away. Wind up and the pitch down low. Runner on third, no outs. There's a strike, 1-2. Sony deals, that's hit foul. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike out number one. That'll bring up a pinch hitter, Jack Carlson, coming to the plate, hitting for Jacob Sashua. Jack Carlson out of Lincoln Sudbury High School, graduated this year. And that ball is going to get by Jacobs. And a run will come around to score as Holzwasser comes in from third base on the wild pitch. 7-0 post 191. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike. Sony deals down low. Well, he's had a battle quite a bit throughout the last few innings. You wonder how much gas he has left. And this is up the middle, past to Sony, and the shortstop will be able to glove it, but not get a throw off. It's a single for Sashua, or excuse me, Carlson, the pinch hitter. Now Ethan McAuliffe, third baseman, steps in. Having a nice day, 2-for-3, also scored two runs today. That one down low. One on, one out, another run in for Sudbury here in the top of the seventh. Sudbury leading Ashland 7-0. And that one is going to get by Jacobs, and Sashua will advance on the wild pitch. And there I go again. Jack Carlson will advance on the wild pitch. Some words of wisdom from Jacobs. Now head coach Derek Johnson going to come check on to Sony. I think he certainly is getting a little bit tired out there, as he's had a couple of very wild pitches, had pretty good control throughout most of the game. And keep in mind, not all of these runs are earned. A couple of the runs scored due to an error. In fact, three of the runs scored due to an error, so only three of the seven or three of the six runs heading into this inning were earned. Two and oh count to McAuliffe as we are ready to continue. Runner on second leading. There's a strike, two and one. Deals. That's a ball, 3-1. Wind up and the pitch. There's ball four. McAuliffe will get a free pass to first base. He'll put two on with one out, and Devin Pathick, the second baseman, coming to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. It's inside. Set the deal. Upstairs. 2-0. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. 2-1. Both runners leading off. Runners on first and second. That's fouled away. 2-2. Pathick steps back in and awaits the pitch. And this is on the ground up the middle, past the reach of DeSoni. Picked up and no, past the shortstop. A runner going to be waved around, and it is going to be 8-0. Jack Carlson comes around to score. McAuliffe up to second, and Pathick reaches on the single. Like it might have went through the shortstop's legs there. You have to look at the tape to figure out exactly how it got by him. Head coach Derek Johnson going to come out and talk to DeSoni, maybe take the ball here. DeSoni has his glove off, so more than likely this will be it for him. And it will. We'll get a relief pitcher, and we'll take a short timeout. Sudbury leading Ashland 8-0 in the top of the seventh. Devin Del Campo moves in from right field to take over on the mound for Miles DeSoni. Miles DeSoni and Devin Del Campo with the simple swap. DeSoni now the right fielder. Gino Fortiani up to the plate. Two on, first and second, one out. Two more runs already in for Sudbury. First pitch up high, 1-0. Devin Del Campo out of Ashland High School will graduate in 2018, or at least set to graduate in 2018, that one down low. Good experience here for young Devin Del Campo. It's a good Sudbury lineup, get to face a few hitters. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. 3-0. Set to deal. There's a strike. Bit of a knuckler there. Both runners leading. And this is crushed into center field. That will drop down. A runner being waved around third. McAuliffe going to come around to score while Pathick will be held up. 9-0 Sudbury. An RBI double for Gino Fortiani, and now Ryan Forrester, the catcher, steps in. Still one out with two on. Both runners in scoring position as that one outside. It was actually Michael Zhang who got that last hit as this one's popped up into right field and will drop in front of DeSoni. Another Sudbury run will come around to score as Pathick comes around. 10-0 on the RBI single by Forrester as Fortiani moves up to third, and now Peter Upham to the plate. Still one out in the inning. There's strike one. Four more runs in for Sudbury in this inning. And this is down the third base side, foul. Down low. One and two on Upham. Upham has scored a run and has an RBI. This is hit in the air over to right field. DeSoni under it makes the catch. Runner's going to tag from third. The throw in is a good one, but it'll pull Jacobs off the plate, and it is 11-0 Sudbury. Fortiani comes around to score on the sacrifice RBI flyout from Upham. Two away as Adam Generoso will step in. And we'll have a pinch hitter, actually. Coming in to hit, Ted McCluskey. There's strike one to McCluskey. McCluskey out of Lincoln Sudbury High School, graduated this year. Wind up and the pitch, upstairs. Runner on first for Sudbury. They have added five more in this inning. There's a strike, one and two. There's strike three. That'll wrap up the top half of the seventh. To the bottom of the inning we go, 11-0 Sudbury. Bottom half of the seventh, Ashland down to their final three outs, trailing 11-0. Stepping in is Samir Sharma. Well, they certainly have their work cut out for them, to say the least. Jack Carlson, the new first baseman for Sudbury is John Rowe still out there trying to go the complete game. First pitch a ball. Sharma 1-for-2 today. Wind up and the pitch is hit foul and out of play. 1-1 to Sharma. Well, Ashland will likely end their season 4-11-1, but a very young team. They got some great experience this year. And last week has been fun to watch. A couple of victories. And Sharma takes a strike there. 1-2. Sharma, Jacobs, and Messier due up. As this is lined over to short. The throw to first in time. Great throw from Holzwesser, who's been out phenomenal defensively in this game. Zach Jacobs will come to the plate. Jacobs and Messier due up. Well, this Sudbury team, they really are a good all-around team. Great defense, some good hitting. And as John Rowe has showed, they at least have one very good pitcher. Swinging strike. And this is hit in the air over to left center, and ranging over to make the catch is the center fielder for the second out of the inning. Nice catch by Fortiani. Mike Messier will come up to the plate. Ashland down to their final out of the season. There's a strike. And this is foul. 0-2. Foul along the third base side by us. Fortunately, the fans behind us are okay. Oh, it was a close call. Thought we were gonna have to sacrifice our cameraman for a second. Is that one down low, 1-2. Well, we have a moment. I want to thank WACA-TV and all the staff at HCAM Television for making these Ashland Legion broadcasts possible. It has certainly been a lot of fun bringing you Ashland Legion baseball once again this season. Is that one outside? 2-2. And a big thanks to our cameraman all season long, Connor Donovan. Did a great job as this one's up the middle over to short. The throw to first is in time, and that will do it for Ashland Legion post 77. The Ashland Legion season not quite over. They will play in the Commissioner's Cup on the road, which is essentially a tournament for the teams that did not make the postseason, but the regular season comes to an end by a final score of 11-0. And also our Ashland Legion baseball broadcasts for the season come to an end as well. Sudbury scored 2 runs in the third, 2 runs in the fourth, 2 runs in the sixth, and added 5 more in the seventh. A great pitching performance by John Rowe. He went the complete game, all 7 innings, only gave up 3 hits to this Ashland lineup, and he only struck out 2 batters, but the defense was certainly very much behind him in this game, and a great defensive performance by Sudbury and a great pitching performance by John Rowe. Well, this Ashland post 77 team, they're young and they certainly have done a lot of developing throughout the season, and I think they'll be back much stronger next year. But in any case, Ashland Legion baseball, always a lot of fun to watch, and it was once again a fun season to bring you these games, but this is a young team with a lot of talent, and they're only going to get better from here. The final score for the final time. Sudbury defeats Ashland 11-0. Ashland will finish the regular season with a 4-11-1 record. Sudbury advances to 11-3. They're on their way to the postseason. They have another regular season game first, so best of luck to Post 191. For Connor Donovan on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Ashland Legion Baseball all season long on HCAM Television in Hopkinton and WACA-TV in Ashland. Thanks again for watching, and enjoy the rest of your day, folks. Take care.
All right, Mike. Well, a tough season over record-wise, but it looked like you guys had a lot of fun out there, a lot of young players that really seemed to develop this year. How do you think the year went?
It was obviously frustrating year record-wise, but it's a great group of guys. We had a lot of fun with it, and it's all you can ask for. So.
And I noticed a lot of the players moved around the diamond a little bit, got to play some different positions. I think I saw you at shortstop a couple times. You moved over to third base. What did you think about the versatility of this team? It seemed like there was a lot of good versatility here.
Yeah, there's a lot of young players that can play a lot of positions, and that's always helpful on a team, and for those individual players moving forward.
All right, well, you're playing over at Clarkson. How's that going for you?
Very good, very good. I love it there.
Excellent. So what's next on the agenda for you this summer?
Just a lot of training, and then heading back to school in August. So.
All right, well, congratulations on a great season, and congratulations on a great Legion career.
Thank you very much.
All right, here with head coach Derek Johnson. Coach, well, a tough season record-wise, but a young team this year, and it seems like everyone got some really good experience this year. Could you just talk about how the year went overall?
Yeah, we kind of similar to last year, started off rough, and then towards the end there we put together a couple good wins, like last night at Natick, coming back, getting that win was big. It started off with the Billrick Avenue forfeit here on Sunday, came back, beat Woburn Natick, so, could have had this game. Miles pitched great. I think if you look at his stats, it was a 12-0 game, but only two runs of those were earned.
Right.
It was a lot of errors, but that's what it is. A young team towards the end of the year, you give kids a chance to play. You hope that they come in and take, the advantage of it, make the plays. A couple of them were tough, so it is what it is. That's the team we have. The kids battled all year. I'm pretty sure a lot of them will say they had a good time. They had a lot of fun doing it too. So,
well, it certainly looked like you guys had fun out there, and a lot of versatility on this team. I noticed guys moving around to different positions a lot. How do you think the players playing different positions and getting good playing time in competitive Legion situations for these young guys will affect the team going forward?
It's good. A lot of the kids that are playing in different positions that's where they normally play. They may have been playing out of position, early on, and it is more so to, help out the team. We only have 18 kids, and then when you lose a couple and you show up with 9, it kind of forces my hand. So I got to put kids where I can. Do I necessarily want to play them at short or second or third or wherever? No, but if I got someone that, depending on who we're playing, you base it off of that. Mess stepping up. He started off at shortstop, the first half of the year, and then he's playing third in college. We want to give him some reps over there. So that opens up an opportunity for one of the younger kids, or like a Mike Krupe, who's normally a second baseman, to get in over there and get some ground balls at short. So, these kids have high school seasons too. You don't want to throw them too much out of position. But it all comes down to the pitching thing, like we talked about earlier. We don't have a staff. I think we got three kids that pitch, and losing Obed to an injury early on. I think he's only thrown 2 games that hurt. So, a lot of kids have been pitching this year. So it opens up spots for other kids.
Right. I don't think you can argue with the valuable experience that a lot of these younger players got this season as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. So, Coach, what's on the slate for you the rest of the summer?
I don't know. A lot of work. It's been going for, I coached the Devils 13U team in town, so that's over. This is over. and then I got a month off, and then AAU picks up again. But we got the Chairman's Cup next week, you know, on Tuesday. So this is the focus right now. Put together some wins, hopefully, through that, make a run, and then end the year on a good note. We'll go from there.
All right. Well, best of luck in the Chairman's Cup, and thanks for another fun season of Ashland Legion Baseball, and we look forward to next year.
Thank you.